بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praise due to Allah. We praise Him and we seek the help from Him. Whomever Allah guide, no one misguide Him. Whomever misguiding, no one will guide Him. I bear witness and testify, there is no worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Muhammad is the last and final messenger. Hayatu al-Sahaba, the life of the Sahaba, the companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We're still talking about the series of Sahabiyat, the female among of the companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And as the ulama defined the Sahaba or Sahabiyat, the one هو من لقي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وآمن به ومات على الإسلام. Whomever met النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم and he believed in the message of the Nabi of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and he or she die in the state of Islam, we consider him or her as a صحابي or صحابية. And all the صحابة رضي الله عنهم, they have high virtue and high value because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised them in the Quran. قال تعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم محمد رسول الله والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم تراهم ركعا سجدا. سبحان الله. والذين معه محمد, Prophet Muhammad and the one with him, أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم, they are strong against the enemies and they are merciful among themselves, and Allah praised them in the Quran. So today inshallah we're going to talk about one amazing sahabiya. Sahabiya, she married with the amazing and the best person who walked over this earth, Nabiullah Muhammadun ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sahabiya, her name Juwayriya bintul Harith radiyallahu anha. Juwayriya bintul Harith radiyallahu anha. Juwayriya bintul Harith radiyallahu anha. Before I start, I would like to mention to you a story how Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to care about the woman. Because women, they are our sister, our mother. The woman is a half of this ummah. And they are the factory for all the ummah. The woman, Islam gave them very high value. And Islam gave them the honor. A story that the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to have a ghulam, a servant person, his name Anjasha. And that Anjasha, during the travel, so because they travel as a caravan and the camels being tied to each other, and the camel, when you sing for the camel in special way, the camel will speed in their walk. So the Anjasha, his job to sing for the camels, and the camels speed so they can finish the travel in the faster period or shorter time. So Anjasha, he has very strong tone and very nice one, which made the camels speed very fast. And who they are sitting on the camel in the Haudaj, and Haudaj is a small house in the top of the camel where the female will sit down. So the camel, when they speed up, it's really shaking the woman and might fall down. So in Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, oh Anjasha, ala rislik, take it easy, rifqan bil qawarir, take it easy and care about qawarir. Qawarir is vases, you know, vases, glasses and vases. So rifqan, be easy and be care about the vases. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the female all of them like glasses, don't broke it. Subhanallah, as in Islam we have a very high value and virtue to the women, and Islam is honor the women. So Juwayriya radiallahu anha, she is one of the women, she is the wife of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Let us start, know her name. Her name fully, hiya Barrah bintu al-Harith bin Abi Dirar bin Habib bin A'idh bin Malik bin Khuza'a. Hiya Barrah bintu al-Harith bin Abi Dirar bin Habib bin A'idh bin Malik bin Khuza'a. So her name Barrah. So when she married with the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam changed her name to Juwayriya. Changed her name to Juwayriya. Her father, who was a leader in the tribes of Bani al-Mustalaq. In the tribes of Bani al-Mustalaq. And those tribes very famous and strong and well known in the Arabic peninsula. Bani al-Mustalaq. So Juwayriya or Barra, she lived in her house, in the house of her father, honored woman, freed one, high status, okay? And she is from the high class family, Arabian one, subhanAllah. So in the beginning of her life, she married with one person, his name Musafih bin Safwan, and he was among of the youth of the Khuza'a. And that time, in the early, before 20 years old. Juwayriya bintul Harith radiallahu anha, how did her story happen and how she married with the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Bani al-Mustalaq, well-known tribes, very powerful, very strong. Their egoist and their hardness make them thinking and plan evil plan. What they plan? They plan to attack Nabi Muhammad ﷺ and the Muslimin and to destroy them and finish them. So when the Nabi ﷺ received the news, the Nabi ﷺ prepared the army and he went to them. And the fight start, the battlefield between the Muslims and the Kuffar, the Mushrikeen, the one they worship the idols. Okay, the war start and the battlefield started. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the victory for the Muslims over the mushrikeen, over the kuffar, the one they worship the idols. After what happened after that, the men, okay, and the women whom were in the battlefield, they become slaves and servants. And that is what it used to be after the war or after the battlefield. Whomever been left will be hostage, and the hostage become like servant from the female. And from the male, it's up to also become a servant. It's up to the leader of the Muslims to kill him or to free him by pay something or free him without any things. It's up to the leader of the Muslims. It depends how enemy that army, you know. But Islam ordered us to be good and kind to the caitiff, okay, the one is hostage. So Islam ordered us to be kind, so we're not allowed to torture them or harm them. We have to give them the word of Islam and take care about them. Then subhanAllah, what happened? Those hostage, from male and female, one of them Juwayriya, and her husband been killed in the battlefield. So she become a slave and servant. When the divide what I mean the in the because after the battlefield will divide whatever they earn from the kuffar. So her comes to be a slave and servant to whom? To Thabit bin Qais bin Shammas al-Ansari. So she said, because she's from high class family, she told him, I want to free myself with money. So he accept. So she paid. She prepared the money to pay him. But in that time, she doesn't have enough money. She doesn't have enough money to free herself to be a free woman, because she cannot accept to be a slave or servant. And the man, he accept, but she must pay the amount. She went all the way to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aisha, what she said about Juwayriya, كانت حلوة ملاحة. حلوة ملاحة. She is very pretty and very sweet and attractive woman. Yani she, because حلوة is a beautiful and sweet, but ملاحة, she has magnetic in her look. So any person see her will be direct to her and interest on to marry her. Then Aisha, she mentioned that. Then she went to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and she asked, Ya Rasulullah, Ana Juwayriya bint al-Harith bin Abi Dirar, Sayyid Qawmi. I am the Juwayriya, the daughter of al-Harith bin Abi Dirar, the leader of the tribes. And you see what happened to me, I become a hostage and I want to free myself. So help me to free myself in financial. And she wasn't Muslim. And she thought maybe she can get some goodness from Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has an amazing hikmah, wisdom. He told her, how about I give you something better? She said, what? He said, I pay the debt on you and you will be freed and I will marry you. Then subhanAllah, she said, yani, she surprised how this will happen. He was a servant slave, then I become a wife for the leader of that tribes, and to not only leader, to messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So something is very, very special, unique. Then her father come in that time and he said, Ya Rasulullah, how come my daughter become slave and servant and we are from high class family? We want to free. And then Nabi Sallam asked her to talk to her. Then she said, the daughter, I accepted to be a wife of a Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I accept this. Later on, her father also become a Muslim. And she also become a Muslim. And then Nabi Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam freed her. Here the moment, what is the beautiful, the hikmah of a Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he married her. When Nabi Sallam married her, all the Sahaba shocked. Ya Allah, how come we will have a hostage and servant and slave from a tribes, and Nabi Sallam marry from them? It's what an embarrassment and what a shame on us to keep them like that. So all the Sahaba freed all the slaves and all the hostage. So nobody remained from the tribes of Bani Mustalik to remain as a hostage or a slave. And it was, subhanAllah, barakah, it's a blessing over her tribes. And this, they say in the narration, no one have a blessing the way Juwayriya had blessing over her tribes. No any wife, subhanAllah, have a blessing over her tribes the way Juwayriya, she had a blessing because all her tribes been freed because of her marriage. Later on, a lot of them, they become a Muslim from Bani Mustalik, because we in Islam, we will not force anybody. It's up to them to accept the faith. Radiallahu anhum wa ardahum. So this is what an honor to Juwayriya radiallahu anha. And Nabi Sallam married her when she was 20 years old. And she become a Muslim and she become a wife of all the believers. كما قال تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وأزواجه أمهاتهم وأولو الأرحام بعضهم أولى ببعض في كتاب الله. سبحان الله. All the wives of Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, they were the mothers of all the believers. The mothers of all believers. سبحان الله. What a great an honor, what a great virtue and value to Juwayriya radiallahu anha to join and to be a member, to be a wife of the best person who walked over this earth, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for your information, it's not the way you think, like Nabi Sallam graving to marry women. In that time, it was the opposite. The women graving to marry with the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the history of his seerah, he rejected some women. They offered themselves, Ya Rasulullah, we want to be wife. And Nabi Sallam said, I can. And even some of the wife offered some member of their family to marry with the Rasul Sallam. And Nabi Sallam, he said, don't offer me your relative or your sisters. So because what a great an honor that to be a wife of the Messenger of Allah. Subhanallah. Now, if I say, if one king of the king of small states, no, I'm not talking about just a small, or a, just a king. Oh, the woman, she's so dreaming to be a wife, to be a prince, whatever. How about not a sultan, is not a king, it's a messenger of Allah, the leader of all the Muslims that time, the one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised him in the Quran. And surely any wife married with the Rasulullah, she will be a company with him in Jannah. That is enough. Enough and honor. So for any trying to put the name of Rasulullah as a womanizer, this is totally wrong. And not only Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he has a polygamy or he married more than one, but all the messengers of Allah before, a lot of them married more than one. Ibrahim alayhi salam, Sulaiman, he married 60 women or more, according in the history, in one day. Sulaiman alayhi salam, and he is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he is so much beloved to the Jews and Christian. So why are you attacking Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and you believe in Sulaiman alayhi salam? So that's an idea. It's been corrupted in our time and trying to harm and make Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam as a low levels. And look at the honor that Nabi, those hostage or this slave and this servant, Nabi some honored her and freed her and give her a name and married her. Not like the a'udhu billah, the shopping of prostitute, those mafias, the when they caught those women, they doesn't have a parents, they doesn't have families, they take advantage out of them and make them work in prostitute place or shopping, and wal'adhu billah, they take them the money from them. A'udhu billah, and they will not say this one it's criminal or evil or what do you call, abused. They doesn't, it's a free, and they give them license. A'udhu billah. I went some of the countries and I so surprised, the house of a prostitute, this is, they have a license by the government and they pay tax to the government of their job. Astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh. Astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh. So subhanAllah, all this is a wrong which Islam to teach us the modesty and akhlaq and manners and iffa and afaf and halal and cleanness. Subhanallah, and honor to the woman, and how to protect our desire and put it in the halal way. Okay, what, how the description of Baraka or Juwayriya? She was very beautiful woman, and she was very intelligent, and she has very sharp, good opinion. Subhanallah, that's her. Also, she has a good akhlaq. And when she talk, she has a very high skills in public speaking or talking to other women. And which Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam select that purpose of da'wah. Because Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he doesn't have so much time to spend with women. Who deliver the da'wah from the wives? And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam working as a leader, as an army, subhanAllah, messengers of Allah with the men all the time teaching them. So Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, in the same time, the wife also worked in the field of da'wah. So she was also working in the da'wah. And she is very clean internally. And she was a taqiyah, has a fearness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And she was faqiha, she's very knowledgeable. And also she narrates some of the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And one of the amazing character she has, she was a abida. What is mean abida? She worship Allah a lot. She worship Allah a lot. And how we know? There is a hadith she narrate, that hadith that an Ujwayriya Umm al-Mu'mineen radiyallahu anha qala marra al-Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed by while she is sitting down in the ground doing dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before the time of Fajr. During the time of Fajr. So Nabi Sallam passed by and give salam and he go to the masjid. After the sunrise, not after Salatul Fajr, after the sunrise, Nabi Sallam returned back home and he saw her sitting in the same position and same place doing dhikr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. Then Nabi Sallam, he said, after I left from you, I mentioned a statement or a words will be more heavier than all the dhikr than when you did during this period of time. And she asked, oh, Ya Rasulullah, what did you say? She want to learn. Then Nabi Muhammad said to her, قُلْتُ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَبِحَمْدِهِ عَدَدَ خَلْقِهِ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ رِضَى نَفْسِهِ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ زِنَةَ عَرْشِهِ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ مِدَادَ كَلِمَاتِهِ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ عَدَدَ خَلْقِهِ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ رِضَى نَفْسِهِ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ زِنَةَ عَرْشِهِ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ مِدَادَ كَلِمَاتِهِ. So this is four statements of four words Nabi Muhammad mentioned, which equal heavier than what she all the time doing the dhikr. And here how to worship Allah in a smart way, you can mention little words which is very heavy in the scales. You can do little ibadah which is very heavy in the scales. So it's not according how much you doing dhikr for how long, is what kind of dhikr you are doing. Quality, subhanAllah, Islam based of quality, and be smart and knock the door of all the gates and door of goodness and ibadah and worship and good deeds. So this is how the believer should do. Look, Juwayriya, she learned, she was abida, she remained and she used to fast. And another narration that when Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he saw, he come to her and she was a fasting. And that day was Friday, Jumu'ah. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked her, did you fast yesterday? She said, no. He said, are you planning to fast tomorrow? She said, no. He said, so break your fast. From this hadith, we understand fasting Friday alone is not the sunnah of a Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you plan to fast Friday, you should be have a schedule of fasting one day before or one day after. So when you have a schedule and the day comes Friday, then you can fast. But it's unique. Because of Friday, I want to fast. This is not the sunnah of a Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also, it's not sunnah in another hadith to unique the Friday for Qiyam. I'm not doing Qiyam Layl at all, only Friday, this is not the Sunnah. So if you want to do Qiyam, do it as a schedule for your Ibadah. And the best Ibadah, أحب العبادات إلى الله أدومها وإن قل. The best Ibadah which Allah loved and liked, that Ibadah continuously, even if that Ibadah is little. Even if that Ibadah is little, more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be continuously. So if you do recite one page a day, follow all your life one page a day. And if you are sick, back up. If you pray two rak'ah, qiyamul layl, follow all your life two rak'ah. No problem how much. It's better than one day you do 20 rak'ah and 1 week you're not doing any rak'ah. So this is not, try to choose a schedule for your, we call it, what I put to, for myself as a schedule of ibadah. They have one word, man shaghalahu hizbuh. We call hizbuk. Hizb mean what you used to recite from Al Quran every day. If you do 10 pages or 5 pages or 1 page, to follow your life. Subhanallah, is very good. SubhanAllah. And if you are doing Qiyamul Layl, something, follow all your life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teach us the right things. So this Juwayriya Abu al-Mu'mineen, the mother of believers, so amazing woman. She's abida, she's have akhlaq, and she's, subhanAllah, pretty woman. She's very good and very kind and very intelligent. Radiyallahu anha. Juwayriya Abu al-Mu'mineen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of her, a lot of people from her tribes become a Muslim, and all her tribes been freed. So what an honor, what an amazing honor to the Juwayriya radiyallahu anha. Juwayriya radiyallahu anha, in the Musnad of Kitab Baqiy ibn Makhlad, she narrated 7 ahadith, and 4 of the ahadith in the book of the Sitta. What is the 6 books? Mean Bukhari and Muslim and Sunan Ibn Majah wa Sunan al-Nasa'i wa Tirmidhi wa al-Nasa'i. So this we call Al-Kutub al-Sitta, the 6 books we find in this 6 books collection of hadith, and she has 4 ahadith, Juwayriya radiyallahu anha. Also, Juwayriya radiyallahu anha, she has an honor to be a friend and companion to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Can you imagine if you met Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam only 5 minutes, and you believe in him and you die in Islam, you consider Sahabi. So how about if you live with the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam for many years? Allahu Akbar, what an honor. SubhanAllah, there's an hadith that a group of people will come after me. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam praised them. And he said, those people, how much they loved me, they wish that they can give everything they have in order to meet me just once. Just a single moment to meet the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We are ready to pay everything you own. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in order to, this is out of the true love towards the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So loving the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a part of Islam. Love Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a part of an Islam. Praising Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam by saying Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's a part of dhikr. One Sahabi said, ya Rasulullah, how much I do from my dhikr to say, to mention your name Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He said, how about third of my dhikr? He said, you will get reward. He said, how about half of my dhikr reward? And long hadith. I tell, how about I do all my dhikr? He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be enough for you for all your which make you worries. Allah will be enough. So that is an honor. If a person always mention the name of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, will purify the heart and make your heart feel calm and happy, and also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be enough for your stress and your problems and your issues. This sunnah, which many people forget to mention, they only mention it in the time of the birthday of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, start singing and praising Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How about after that? How many a day we ask ourselves, we praise the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we value him and we loved him, and we say how much he spent from his life, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of him, moved us from the darkness to the light, saves us from the darkness to the light. So always make your tongue mention the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and say Muhammadun sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Juwayriya, she leave after Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam pass away. She accept and she remain in belief until the Khilafah of Muawiyah bin Abi Sufyan. So she lived for a long life. Until the Khilafah of Muawiyah bin Abi Sufyan radiallahu anha, and she died in the Rabi'ul Awwal from the year of 50 of the Hijrah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Sahaba did janazah and pray for her janazah, and she been buried where? In Al-Baqi'. Buried where? In Al-Baqi'. So in Al-Baqi', the grave next to the Masjid of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so many Sahaba and the wife of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being buried there. So this Qubur or this grave, it's very special. It has a speciality. And who prayed for her janazah? Marwanu ibn al-Hakam radiyallahu anha wa ardaha. جزاها الله عنها كل خير. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us with Juwayriya, Umm al-Mu'mineen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teach us to learn a lesson from this beautiful story. Take a lessons in our life to be a da'iya, to be a good, to be a good akhlaq, good behave. Take an opportunity to be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and don't hesitate to try all your best to be a closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. جزاكم الله خيرا وأحسن الله إليكم وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا. نعم نعم. Until now, still the Muslims still being buried in Baqi'. I have two relatives of mine being buried in Baqi', my uncle. My mother, she been buried in next to Shuhada Uhud, the graves of the Shuhada of Uhud, being buried there. In Baqi'. Until now they still, but now they made the grave of Baqi' only for the people in Medina. Only. They will not accept people from outside Medina. Yeah, for example, a person, not about full, it's just like they put the law. may be full, I don't know, because Baqi'a, subhanAllah, although it's big, but a lot of people be buried. So it's because my mother lived in Saudi Arabia for quite long, yes. SubhanAllah.